Welcome to a new video which is about solving limit questions in an undefined condition, 0 times infinity. I will show you a general strategy to solve such questions and then solve instructive examples to illustrate the subject. If this is your first time here and if you want to support this channel, don't forget to subscribe, click on the bell to turn on the notifications to be aware of the upcoming videos. We have a lot to cover, so let's get started. Okay guys, in this topic we will consider the case where we have such a case 0 times infinity. Of course, in order to obtain this we should have two terms. Let's say this is the first term, where when x goes to infinity limit of f of x is 0. For the second term, let's say we have such a limit and the result of that limit is infinity. If we have such a case like f of x times g of x when x goes to infinity, and if the result is 0 times infinity, then we convert this case either something like this or something like this. If we look at the first case, we see that we convert 0 times infinity in a case where we have 0 divided by 0, or we convert this to a case where we have infinity divided by infinity. And in order to convert the given limits, we use this strategy. Okay, we use the denominator as 1 divided by g of x. So once you write the whole term as f of x divided by 1 divided by g of x, and then we can obtain 0 divided by 0 or infinity divided by infinity from here. We have an example for that, and let's take a look at the example that we have here. If you see that when x goes to infinity, then this part is gonna be infinity times, because of the power of e, which is negative here, okay? So if you increase the x, then this is going to go to 0. So as you can see, we have a case where the result is infinity times 0. But here, if we write this term as limit when x goes to infinity, x to the power of 3 times, we can write e to the power of negative 2x as 1 divided by e to the power of 2x, guys. And this is gonna be equal to, guys, limit when x goes to infinity x cubed divided by e to the power of 2x. And now which one goes faster? If you look at the degree of the numerator, which is 3, and if you look at the degree of the denominator, which is 2x, and when x goes to infinity the denominator goes faster, and because of that this is gonna be like 1 divided by infinity. Actually, it's not 1, but it's going to be some number, let's say c constant, okay? Some number divided by infinity. We're going to have 0 as a result of this limit. So in this limit, the result is 0, guys. And let's take a look at the next example. Okay, guys, in the next example, we have limit when x goes to 0, x times cotangent x. And if you put 0 instead of x, we have 0 times cotangent is cosine over sine. So as you can see, sine 0, if you approach 0 from right or left, then our function goes to infinity, okay? So we have something like 0 times infinity situation here. So that means we need to find a way to get rid of this situation. So how we can do that? Well, if you write limit when x goes to 0, x times, instead of cotangent, I'm going to write 1 divided by tangent, guys, tangent x. And in the next step, I'm going to write limit when x goes to 0. I'm going to have x divided by tangent x. And then we have limit when x goes to 0, x divided by tangent x. This is one of the formula that we're going to use also in limit of trigonometric functions, where the answer is 1, guys. My upcoming topic is going to be about limit in trigonometric functions. And as I will show over there, the limit of x divided by tangent x when x goes to 0, this is equal to 1, guys. So the answer is B in this case. And let's continue with the next question. In this question, it says when x goes to infinity, what is the value of x times sine 1 divided by x? If you put infinity instead of x, we're going to have here infinity times sine 1 divided by infinity, which is 0, right? So sine 0 is 0, guys. And as you can see from here, we have infinity times 0 condition, which is an undefined condition. So we need to find a way to write x times sine 1 divided by x in a different way. Let me write the question here again. Limit when x goes to infinity. Instead of x, I'm going to write x as 1 divided by 1 divided by x. Why? Because from here, this is equal to 1 times we are dividing 1 by 1 divided by x. So in the next step, it's going to be 1 times x divided by 1. Still, we're going to have x from here. Anyway, so I'm going to write the rest of this, which is sine 1 divided by x, guys. Now, in the next step, I'm going to have a limit when x goes to infinity. And if you multiply 1 by sine 1 divided by x, then we're going to have sine 1 divided by x divided by, in the denominator part, I'm going to have 1 divided by x, guys. And here, when x goes to infinity, okay, sine divided by, okay, there was such a formula, let me remind you, from limit of trigonometric functions, again, limit when, let's say, x goes to 0, sine x divided by x, and we have 1 in this case. So, we have a similar situation here. When x goes to infinity, 1 divided by infinity is 0, right? So, it's going to be like sine of 0. So, because this part goes to 0, that part goes to 0 as well. So, that case is the same as this case. So, I'm going to have 1 also in this case. So, our answer is going to be B in this case. Okay, guys, this is our last question in this video. We have a similar question comparing to previous one. And in this one also, we have when x goes to infinity, what is the value of 5x times sine 3 divided by x? If you put infinity instead of x, from here we're going to have infinity times sine 0 is going to be 0. So, we're going to have an undefined condition, infinity times 0. So, we need to write it in a different way. Here, what we can do is, as we did in our previous example, limit when x goes to infinity, guys. I'm going to have here 5 times 1 divided by 1 divided by x, guys, times sine 3 divided by x. And then, because here, if you divide 1 by 1 divided by x, we're going to have still x, and if you multiply that x by that 5, we're going to have still 5x. And in the next step, I'm going to have limit when x goes to infinity, 5 times, and now I'm going to have sine 3 divided by x divided by 1 divided by x. And I need to make, because there is 3, okay, so I need to have 3 also here. Why? Because I want to benefit the formula that I previously wrote, which one was limit when x goes to 0, sine of x divided by x. So that part and this part has to be same. And as you can see, we have 3 divided by x here. So if I put here 3, okay, and then I have to put 3 in the numerator also in order not to change the value of the given expression. And once you do it, we're going to have limit when x goes to infinity, 15 times sine 3 over x divided by 3 over x. And now 3 over x goes to 0. You can think it in this way. When x goes to 0, we're going to have 15 times 1, which is 15, guys. 15 times 1, which is 15. Let me write it here. So the result is 15 in this case. That's the last question in this video, guys. If you have any question, you can put them in the comment section below. Thank you for watching, and hopefully see you in the upcoming videos.